with the victory. And in this game, it looks like they're actually going to pick up what I think is now becoming their favorite support duo with the Disruptor and Ancient Apparition.
It actually just dominated Virtus Pro in that series yesterday. It literally just killed all Virtus Pro.
They picked it three times, I think.
Yeah, in the last game, the last game that they had Disruptor, he glimpsed maybe four heroes back before they BKB, glimpsed them back, then got off the Static Storm so that they couldn't use their BKB, and they just proceeded to fall within an instant, so...
Well, they were actually doing it with a Naga, so if you get the Naga Sleep off someone, no one's gonna BKB a Naga Sleep, and then if the Disruptor ults on top of that, you actually can't pop your BKB at that point, and you just die. So I'm actually curious to see if they're actually gonna go for the Naga Siren again. It is quite a strong combo if you can get up to that Aghanim's on Disruptor. And Disruptor is also a hero that is quite good against Slark, which is probably, I would say, the most successful hero for Virtus Pro Polar. I think I was looking at the stats of something like they have a 75% win rate with quite a few games, so yeah, Illidan definitely...
Good luck ulting now when a Static Storm is on you. Ha, yep. Take that. Freaking Slark. Dumb fish thing. I don't even know what that is. Slaughter actually, at the very least, you know what he is. I don't know what Slark is. Although Slaughter's model is... He's a pretty terrible thing. He needs to be... I don't think Illidan had any items either, so... You can't be like, oh, he's got cosmetics. No, that's not the case. It just looks awful. Freaking Slaughter, man.
And Virtus Pro Polar... Get the Venomancer and Visage. I wonder if it's going to be a core or a support Venom. We always talk about this, but I personally think support or core. I think they always run it as a core with Phobos playing it, so that's what I expect in this game as well. They go ahead and pick up a Visage, not a hero that we see too much without the pairing of Drow Ranger because, you know, you lose a lot of effectiveness. I don't think they'll be picking a Drow here, although it is possible. I just think it's unlikely. And Secret go for the Juggernaut. This is a hero I think has been buffed so many times and is now definitely a relevant hero. You know, before you could say, you know, his base damage was really terrible, and if he had any contest in his lane, you know, CSing was a complete nightmare because I think you had 47 damage with your items, but now you get 53, I believe. So he got a nice buff as well as getting one additional armor at level 1, so the Jug buffs are very significant, and the last time I saw Secret playing Jug, I was very impressed by Kuroki's build. He actually goes for a non-standard build. He gets, I believe he went 1 point into Blade Fury, 2 points in Healing Ward, 1 point in Crit, and then he gets stats, and he just goes his farming build with Mask of Madness and Mjolnir, and he actually just farms at an insane rate.
I saw you doing that in one of your pub games the other day. You were streaming, and it actually worked out quite well for you. You carried that game pretty well. Shoutouts to you. Nice job. I like the Juggernaut pick as well, but Visage, Skywrath Mage, Venomancer Core for Virtus Pro Polar, and the Lycan fifth pick, because why not? They went to Walmart, and they get it for the value. Clearance sale
that,
Lycan pick.
That fifth pick Dire Lycan. How does that even happen? And actually, it's sort of a denial pick as well. I think Lycan would have been very good for VPP. If you look at their heroes, Lycan, Visage, definitely a nice synergy between those heroes, and it would give them... Although, I guess... No, the laning would be completely fine. They would just put Lycan mid... I think that would have been very strong, and then they could have even aggro tri-laned and then put Slark in a 1v1.
5 seconds remaining. Well,
that might have actually been not only a good pick for themselves because it's on Dire and value, like you said in the last pick, but I think it's also a denial pick as well.
Mm-hmm. We'll see what Virtus Pro Polar ends up here with their fifth pick. They have plenty of reserve time left. Mm-hmm. Do apologize again for the stream issues.
Is it fixed now?
It should be.
No more.
There was a frame drop. There was like seven or eight threads on Reddit about people just flaming of me not noticing the lag, even though I there's not really much I could have done during the game anyways, so...
Yeah, I mean, it was only happening at the end anyway. I had the stream on the other monitor, and I was like, oh boy. But apparently the audio was good, so it was a radio cast.
Yeah, whatever. Apparently people said it was throughout the entire game. I don't think that's the case. It lagged twice in Dota. I didn't have any stream frame drops, apparently, and it was at the end of the game,
It wasn't the whole game, I don't think. But obviously, I'm not watching very closely.
I blame you.
Me? So, they're taking quite a long time on this last pick. What could they possibly pick? A mid-hero, I imagine. So, something for Meg. What's actually available for him to pick at this point? That would be good. Nightstalker's Band. Or they could even do something like a Spirit Breaker. I know they really like that hero. Maybe offlane a Spirit Breaker and put Venomancer mid. I think that could also be an option for them.
20 seconds left of reserve time for Virtus Pro Polar. They have a lot of options. That's the case. That's true. So they can get away with a lot.
They need something to deal with this Jug. They have the Skywrath Silence, but that is the only disable they have for Jug, and you really can't let him get off good ultimates in these fights. They're actually going to go...
Roar is one of them.
Yeah, I like this pick. I think it's going to be an offlane Beastmaster, and then a mid-Veno.
This is not a hero I see them run too often. This is a denial type of hero. Beastmaster is picked up often for Mad and his squad, and it's not a hero that I see Virtus Pro Polar play particularly well, but... And we'll see how it pans out as the game is going to get underway in just a moment. Now,
this is a sort of curious draft from VPP, though. I don't really see like the natural synergy with these heroes. You know, Beastmaster and Sark are going to provide them with a lot of map control, but they sort of have this Venomancer who wants to push, but then you have a Sark who doesn't, you know, that's not really his thing. It's just sort of a wonky draft, it seems like. And Visage Skywrath is not really a support duo that you're like, oh, that makes a lot of sense.
No, not really. When I see Visage Skywrath, I don't really think about how they sit together.
And usually you want a pairing with Skywrath that's very aggressive, you know, something like a Sand King, maybe. Some magical damage as well as having a stun, so you can get the full duration Skywrath ult off, but not really having anything this game.
So, Virtus Pro Polar going up against Secret. I think if Virtus Pro Polar lose this game, I mean... 3-0 is definitely a possibility between these two squads in Secret with a 1-0 victory. And that 1-0 victory, that's a backbreaker, man. Even in the first game, that is a momentum killer. Virtus Pro Polar off to a 1-0 start. Secret could easily come back from that, but Virtus Pro Polar now are the ones going to be tested here.
Probably feeling like they should have won that game. Maybe, you know, psychologically detrimental when, you know, you feel like you had the game in the bag and then you just sort of throw it away, but... Hopefully they can bounce back in this game, not let that previous game and mistakes affect their mentality. I think VPP is an experienced enough team to not allow that to happen. So I expect them to bounce back this game.
I don't know, though. With this draft, I mean, I know Illidan is playing Slark, and that's their hero.
That is probably his best hero. Slark and Medusa, definitely their most successful heroes.
I think that the Slark is the only really part of this lineup that I'm like, yeah, okay, this really is going to be good. I mean, because... We've seen the evidence of No-Tail's Disruptor absolutely destroy people. We've seen the evidence of Kuroki's and destroy... We've seen the evidence of... Well, maybe not Misery Juggernaut, but S4 Puck destroy people.
What is going on?
I don't know what's happening right now. Pause, XD.
Puppies, having... I don't exactly... I really think this Lycan pick was a complete denial coming out, because... They spent so much time on this last pick, and this Beastmaster pick, it almost seems sort of forced. I'm not too sure what he's going to be able to accomplish in this. I'm sure he's going to have the roar for the Lycan and the Jug, which is pretty nice, but... And I guess you have the roar plus the Skywrath ults, but it's not a hero that we see too often.
Where are they sending these supports from Virtus Pro Polar? They're not going top, are they? Because safely in Illidan, Stormmage Slark, he needs to get farm early on to be effective, I think, and... Him not getting CS lane is a problem.
Is this an aggro tri-land coming up from Secret?
It most certainly is. Solo safe lane Lycan.
Oh, it's Kuroki's actually... Okay. I thought it was going to be an offlane Puck, a mid Lycan, a safe lane Jug, but it's actually going to be a safe lane Lycan.
I think I'd rather have Puck in the safe lane and then Kuroki mid currently, because Kuroki's not going to get farm, whereas with Lucer Orb and the range that S4 has, he could get farm theoretically.
Yeah, but who expects this aggro tri-land coming up from VPP? I mean, this is not a lane that you're expecting.
There's a ward in the base for the dire side. I think that's a misclick.
Oh, no. Oh, maybe that's what the pause was for. Maybe someone paused and then they were flaming each other. Like, LOL. You're bad.
We'll see how it pans out. It is actually going to be Misery in the solo offlane. And the lanes were saved accordingly.
Make this mistake occasionally.
Yeah, see, if you're in a game and you do this, which I'm sure many people have in the past, just don't fret. Also, this boar is pulling two creeps back through the wave.
No, it's not an aggressive tri-lane.
No, yeah, they changed everything up. It's defensive tri-lane on both sides.
It looks like they were actually just trying to contest the bounty runes.
Did Virtus Pro Polar get... Yeah, they got the top bounty rune, and then Misery got the bottom bounty rune, so they actually just ended up exchanging them.
I mean, the Bounty Ruin at level 1 is actually very, very important.
Mag, No-Tail Hell has already used Glimpse, and he's actually pretty tanky. He does stay alive. They almost got the kill there. No-Tail takes too much damage. He has to back away. No salve. He actually has to regen using his Tango, so... All right. Okay.
Yeah. The level 1 bounty gives half a level and 100 gold, so it's very significant to get that at level 1.
Mm.
And if you can get both, you actually get a tremendous advantage.
That's how you win the game, man. Level 1 bounty runes. If you get both of them, you've won the game. I wonder what the percentage is on win rate if you get both level 1 bounty runes. There's got to be a stat for that at some
point. I
mean,
obviously, it doesn't, like, win you the game, but it is, I think, a nice advantage to get both of them.
It's a joke, dude.
I'm aware, but you get a level advantage pretty much off the bat if you get both of them.
No, yeah, it's pretty good. It is literally a level advantage if you get both of them. Kuroki is going to head up top. He's going to get 4 last hits currently. Down bottom, Misery is going to get Arcane Bolted. He should be okay. Again, the Ancient Seal. Mag, it glimps back. Nope. That boar is actually killing No-Tail.
They go ahead and kill it off. Well, they have Howl plus Chilling Touch. That's a scary amount of damage.
There is no way that should have happened. That should not have happened.
Oh, and he's going to live.
He actually is fine, too. 2-minute rune, he's going to spawn as a regen. Ah, if only it was regen.
I actually completely missed that. I was not expecting something.
No
like
one
that
was
to
expecting
happen.
That bottom. Oh.
Okay, Misery actually does the really smart play, not going for that bounty rune. Most players, I think, would have gone for that bounty rune.
He wants that bounty rune. He has the ward here, so he knows Lil is here. He's just like, that's fine. I'm not going to die for that bounty rune. So
he actually sees him. I'm dumb.
So far, so good, especially considering Misery got first blood, but it does look like Illidan is free farming as his Kuroki in the top lane. But at some point in time, I mean, you talked about Chilling Touch and Howl together. Battling is going to occur, and Secret's battle is a bit better early on, I think, than perhaps Virtus Pro Polar's battle, other than obviously the Visage Soul Assumption. I don't know. This could be interesting, the way this pans out. We'll have to wait and see.
Yep, and pretty soon Phobos is going to be, once he gets that level 5, it's just going to be a wall of wards in the mid lane. And sure, S4 might be able to farm, but he's not going to have the most fun of times farming under his tower.
No, this sucks, man. This is not an enjoyable time for S4 currently. And these wards actually take 3 hits to kill, too, so...
He's getting a lot of farm. I'm actually surprised that Phobos is actually using these level 2 wards, because he's sort of feeding some farm and experience towards the puck.
Mm-hmm. I mean, S4 will get his boots up soon, and...
Puck is actually level 5 before Phobos now because
Magnetic
of this.
Magnetic Field, and here comes the Lycan. The Lycan Wolves as well. Cold Feet going in, blocked by the Wolves, and that's an easy kill for Secret. Mm-hmm. Good body blocks from the Wolves, and obviously the Kinetic Field making it so Cold Feet was going to proc no matter what happened.
This lane from Secret, this support duo with the Ancient Apparition and Disruptor, it is so strong at getting these early kills. Like, the Glimpse into Kinetic Field plus Cold Feet, and then you have damage on top with the Chilling Touch, it's a guaranteed kill every time if you get the Glimpse off.
Misery goes for Double Circlet, by the way. The strong combo. We've seen this so often now that the Circlet, I think money was changed the cost of it, so...
Yeah, it's pretty cost-efficient at this point. 4-minute
rune, bounties picked up for him, some extra gold going his way.
Yeah, Misery's doing a great job against this tri-lane. You know, he got the kill, which, you know, shouldn't happen, and then he's controlling the bottom runes as well.
And that was first blood gold as well that he got. But the problem is that where is he going to get experience? I mean, bottom line, he was up for a little bit. Dreamcoil is going to go in casually onto Phobos. Lucio Orb doesn't connect, but there is going to be the Blade Fury. They're going to jump back in, and they get the kill. The Courier was also getting brought low, but it's not going to get killed. So S4 gets the kill, popping off the coil, and they clean up these wards, and that actually gives Misery his 3. Top lane, Mag is a haste rune. Kuroki is still contesting his farm there, but wrapping in
actually...
on the backside.
Okay, so one of my friends who's been offlaning Jug recently, he gets... Obviously, you couldn't do this in this game, but he gets Healing Ward level 1, and then level 2, he gets Crit. He buys a Quelling Blade, and you can actually do Ancients with the change to Crit. It's 20% now, and then you just use the Healing Ward to heal yourself. You can actually do Ancients, so... Be interesting to see if that ever happens in a pro game.
I mean, if it's good, if it's viable, I'm certain someone will try it.
But it's mostly when you can't get any experience out of the lane. Because I think the experience that you get from Ancients is a bit less than what you would get from just sitting in the lane.
It takes a long time, I imagine. Not the easiest thing in the world. Illidan and Misery playing Ring Around the Rosie down bottom. Illidan has Pounce. Misery has Blade Fury. They're going to go toe-to-toe for the time being. Illidan has Essence Shift. He'll win a matchup generally. But there's Blade Fury. And now with no Pounce, Illidan is in trouble. Illidan might die here. And Misery gets another kill. And that's actually even more huge than the first one that he had gotten.
Well, Misery playing out of his mind right now.
Virtus Propeller, maybe Tilting?
Level 3 against a level 5 Slurk, and he just 1v1s him. It's just straight up.
Acid Shift should win the battle here, and then Blade Fury comes out and, like, nope.
All right,
Misery
is
dead now, I think, though. Ancient Seal, the right click. Arcane Bolt, not there. He already used it. Misery's out of mana still. Nope, he has Blade Fury. Here comes S4, Dream Coil. Can he get either of these kills? Waiting Rift, they're going to get one. Misery stays alive for the time being. Finally, Soul Assumption, but S4 will get two kills. He's going to get the double. Illidan is back in, but no Pouncy. He pops up the Shadow Dance. S4 is in trouble, pops off the Illusion Orb, jaunts away, and they get out scot-free. Despite losing Misery on the back end, and S4 now having a heck of a game.
But 2-1-3 already on this jug. Like, what is going on? BPP are just falling apart in this laning phase. This should not be happening, especially not with the heroes that they have.
It's certainly not looking good, to say the very least.
And I mean, he's gonna have his ults, like, this is going to be a very early Omni Slash free.
Mag is going to get caught top lane again, but more TP rotations. No Tail taking some damage. Mag, he's at level 3. Cold Feet doesn't proc. Soul Assumption, no Tail, no TP money. Now he has it. He might buy it quickly before he dies just to make sure he gets something. Yeah. Throws up another Thunderstrike. Kuroki was in the jungle, and yeah, that's he was too far away.
Mm-hmm. But in the end, he doesn't lose any gold there. Kuroki does pick up the Vlad, so that's going to increase his farm rate very significantly. Although this is stacked, that's not what you want as a Lycan player.
He doesn't seem to mind.
I mean, he can still clear it, it's just not as efficient.
Does he have, yeah, his Vlads are done like you mentioned, and he has a medallion coming out soon. Dire Lycan, Vlad's medallion, go time is soon for Roshan.
And this is the advantage that you get when you have this Lycan. You can clear out, you can just do the jungle as the Lycan and give your supports all the freedom and levels that they desire. Puppy is sitting at about level 4.5, and what's Snowtail at? Pretty much
level
the same
four.
Thing.
Yeah.
If you compare to that to the supports on the other team, they're about a level ahead on one of the heroes, so. But that should start to skyrocket because they're getting the entire lane of experience now.
Yeah, Ice Blast and Static Storm coming out, that's going to be huge. Misery also gets the mid-levels as well because S4s go on bottom, and he is in trouble. Avoids a lot, but not the silence coming out from
FNG. Okay,
Dream Coil, Waiting Rift, he's going to try to kill one of these heroes. It's not going to be FNG. They don't need Omni Slash, although he had it.
Yeah.
So another easy kill for Misery just to help out. I mean, and that... The presence of mind for S4 there, he could have died, but he actually just Dream Coils and kills one and forces a TP on the other.
Yeah, they actually use the Howl, and that's another advantage that Lycan gives you. You can globally help your team on the other side of the map. Giving 14 damage is very significant at this stage in the game. And, wow, Misery's farm is exceptional as well. He has Phase Boost Bracer working towards, it looks like, most likely the drums. They're going to smoke up three of these heroes. They actually have the healing ward as well, so he can actually just pop the healing ward, stick it in Roshan with Kuroki, and they can do this Rosh very easily.
This should not be an issue.
FNG actually is going to break. You know, they're just going to kill FNG instead.
Shapeshift, body block from the wolves again, but...
Yeah, there's nothing
concussive
you can do.
Shot's not going to do anything, and FNG is going to try to deny himself to the wolves, and does.
Oh, he actually gets
wow.
to deny.
The alpha wolves. Best wolves. DK Phobos coming through, and he can't do much there. Top lane is getting assaulted, by the way. Mag is like, I might be dead here. Ice Vortex, they have vision. He's going to try to TP away. Misery going to come in. Omni Slash is going to go. Cancels the TP, the glimpse as well. And well, they didn't need the Omni Slash. Had No-Tail gotten that glimpse off, which he did, but they get the kill regardless. So
yeah, it's not. I mean, kill for Omni Slash, completely fine. Especially the level 1 Omni, which actually isn't too effective in teamfights.
Yeah. And now Misery is getting up there in terms of farm.
Yep.
They are pushing bottom lane with Illidan, but this is not like a pushing lineup, unlike the one Secret has. No-Tail heads over bottom. He has Static Storm, by the way, ready to go. And they just back off to the tower. They want to try to take this. And S4, rather, Kuroki picks up his medallion. S4 sits mid. He's trying to pick up his Blink Dagger. In fact, he has enough money to buy it currently. He will sail it out soon. And then at that point, they are in trouble.
Midas picked up for Illidan on the Slurk, but Secret are just being so efficient with the map right now. On top of all these kills that they're acquiring, they have the Lycan farming up the jungle, like we said. The supports are just getting so much experience from the top lane. And VPP aren't really doing anything to punish, but what can they do after this terrible start from the bottom lane? Like, these supports in the bottom lane, they got underleveled, they died even, and what a game coming up from Misery on the jug.
Yeah, he's been the backbone of the team, and so far he's been the one contributing a lot of these kills. He's obviously sitting at 3-1-4. So he's been involved in 7 of the team's 9 kills, which is pretty huge. S4 as well has been involved in a lot of them, 4 of them in fact. But for now, it's just kind of farming up and proceeding to maybe take objectives pretty soon here once Kuroki maybe gets another item or when he takes Roshan. They smoked up. The smoke was not used to take Rosh. Decided against it. S4's Blink Dagger is done. I mean, they have all of the items pretty much to make a go. I think. I don't know if they really need anything else to try to fight or to try to take Roshan anytime soon.
Yeah, and usually when you have the Slark hero, you have that late game security, but he's pretty much the only hero on the side of VPP that scales into the late game.
And against Venom, I'm pretty not really good,
but I mean, Secret have so much damage coming out from the late game and the Juggernaut. And the Healing Ward is going to be very effective too. Who's going to kill the Healing Ward in teamfights? I guess that the birds.
Visage, the birds could, the birds, Visage can, or maybe even the long range of the Skyrath Mage, but.
Yeah, but I mean, if those heroes are hitting, it's going to be the birds, because if either of the supports are hitting the Healing Ward, they're probably dead.
Observer Ward on the Ancient stack does spot out the fact that they're stacking this. Number one, it does cancel out the stack. Number two, so at some point in time, you could expect Secret to head over there. Mag has a Haste Rune. He has Primal Roar. Now he's going to use that on a Puppy. He got the Ice Blast off. There's the Axis Soul Assumption. They bring down one. Misery doesn't want to Omni Slash. They have the birds nearby, and they get a quick kill. And this does actually allow Kuroki head over to the Roche Pit, so.
Wait, does Omni Slash actually hit birds?
It should, right? It's physical damage. Correct?
Yeah, I guess so. But it would one-shot them, I believe, because it does additional damage. Are birds considered creeps? Omni like one-shots creeps, right? I wonder if it one-shots birds or not.
I think they're considered more as hero units. Damage. They're more. I don't think they're gonna one. I wouldn't think you would one-shot them. Meanwhile, Rosh, Static Storm, Illidan already used to Shadow Dance. They have vision of him. Thunderstrike is gonna go glimpse back in, and Roshan and No-Tail will take care of him. Even if No-Tail dies, he gets killed by Rosh. He denies himself. And now the Omni Slash coming in. Misery takes one. He's looking for DK Phobos. He doesn't have his Blade Fury, unfortunately. The Wolf's chasing after him, shouting him, get to cancel this out quickly. They won't continue onward here. Although Kuroki did go down, by the way, to the fray that was happening currently in the Rosh Pit. So they knew that was happening. The Observer Ward was there. Disconnect coming out from Illidan Stormrage. He's having some trouble, clearly. See, even pro players have internet issues, guys.
So that was a strong play from VPP to deny the Rosh attempt. They do trade 2-for-2, so in the end, it was a pretty even exchange. Although, No-Tail actually died to Rosh, so even a positive exchange there. And I'm not sure that VPP can contest Rosh again. They can. I think Secret can just walk back into Rosh once they respawn. And I'm not sure. What can VPP actually do about that? Maybe they send the birds, possibly, but I don't think they're contesting Rosh at this point, and a Midas pickup actually for Misery, so looking to scale even harder into the late game.
Yeah, this is really gonna, I think, the Midas for Slark is good, but when you have Kuroki, number one, helping you out with Misery, number two, I think they have more than enough ways to take this late, and even if Slark becomes a powerhouse, they can, I mean, we saw No-Tail actually solo, pretty much solo, Illidan on that Slark with the Static Storm, and he's so good at using a Static Storm, glimpsing at the last second as he's trying to leave when the Kinetic Field is over, and then Rosh is able to deny No-Tail because that's just, well, not. It's just going their way at this point. You can't say anything else other than Secret are having this game go their way. They're going to get Roshan, they're going to get Aegis, there's no way they're contesting this for Virtus Pro Polar. They're down how much gold? 4,000 in net worth. Experience-wise, it's 5,000. They have 5 kills to their name. And now at this point, Secret could also just afford to either split push, to ball up, to fight. They could do whatever they possibly want to do.
Looks like we might see an engagement in the bottom lane. FNG and Lil look like they want to initiate on this, but it's going to be a 3v3.
Dark Pack
going
in.
Oh, the pound misses.
And Misery does get silenced up anyway, so he's going to fall. Ancient Seal was more than enough. Illidan is going to try to go No-Tail as he TPs away. Dark Pack does a lot, but not enough. S4 jaunts into the trees. Mag is looking for Wild Axes. S4 TPs out as well. So they lose Misery. They gain nothing out of it. Good fight coming up from Virtus Pro Polar. That's what they need to do. They need to find some ancient seals. Even if Illidan misses his pounce, it doesn't matter. Mag couldn't get off his Blitzcurry fast enough. He couldn't get off his Omni Slash fast enough. However, with that being said, Kuroki is going towards the mid lane, and even with the Venom Scale, they don't give a damn. They want this tier 1 tower. They want it damn now, so.
Mm-hmm. And it actually looks like Illidan's going to be going for a Shadow Blade this game.
No deny coming out. The Illidan Shadow Blade coming out. Yeah, we've seen so many different Slark builds. I don't know
so
how I feel about
different
this.
Builds. I want to ask him why he swaps builds. Because I think the other day he was going S and Y and then into Scotty with no mobility item in either the Shadow Blade or the Blink Dagger. And I wonder what prompts the item change.
Uh-oh, Static Storm, they catch out Illidan here, but is there enough damage? It doesn't look like a Dream Coil. Now that it goes through Omni Slash and onto DK Phobos as well. Mag is low, pops the Healing Ward up. Do they have enough damage to kill him? They kill the Healing Ward. S4 comes back in, decides to just walk away. Grave Chill goes, the bird's chasing him down. It's a one-for-nothing exchange thus far. Mag coming in, he already used his Primal Roar. S4 is going to jaunt away into the river. Still slowed up by Poison Sting and the Boar Poison as well. DK Phobos getting Thunderstruck, Kinetic Fielded back, and Glimpses Weld. But there's no follow-up damage there. Misery is too low. He can't pop up the Blade Fury and survive successfully.
Well,
and they don't have any of the heroes
from
S4.
That would have been a kill had he hit that orb, but nice attempt from S4 to get that kill. And, I mean, Secret get what they want. They kill the priority target. Slark is the number one priority for Secret to kill, and this Disruptor just doing so much work against this Slark. He just gets glimpsed into Static Storm, Kinetic Field, and there's nothing he can do at that point.
FNG gets caught out, and the Ice Blast came in, Waiting Rift comes through, Dark Patch off, Kinetic Field goes, Thunderstrike goes as well, but there's no Static Storm for No-Tail. TP taking too long for Misery, but here come the Wolves, and the Necro One, they have the Cold Feet in place. Dark Patch going, Illidan's gonna pounce out. Do they have the Glimpse? It's available in 13. They cannot chase after Illidan, although he is taking a lot of damage. The Mana Burn came in, I believe, from the Necronomicon Archer. And able to burn all of his mana. Kuroki's not even there. How does he get his creeps all the way over there? I think he TP'd towards the bottom lane and let his creeps do the rest of the work. They're going to take the tier 1 tower top. Aegis is still up on him. Point booster for Misery. He's going for Aghanim Scepter. They're going to continue to push here. And Virtus Pro Polar have to try to defend. Maybe a tier 2. We'll see.
Yeah. I'm not sure what the plan is at this point for VPP. It sort of seems like they're just getting rolled over because the team fights are going to be extremely difficult up against a Secret lineup. They have so many tools. They have the Coil, they have all the spells from Disruptor, they have the Omni Slash, the Healing Ward, and the Lycan ult. I just don't think VPP have enough in these team fights. Sure, Roar is a decent spell at picking people off, but it's not really a team fighting spell. The only real team fighting hero that they have is the Venomancer ult, and sure, he has the Axe, but is that going to be enough?
Kuroki needs to leave. Although S4 comes in and kills him immediately, DK Phobos gets brought down, Mag chasing after with the Roar. Here's Illidan, Shadow Bladed up, he's looking for a pounce, he's gonna find it onto S4. Omni Slash is available, and Illidan pops the Shadow Dance just in time. S4, Phase Shift not there, he's in trouble, he's gonna jaunt away, he won't make it out in time. Now Illidan is gonna fall though, Kuroki gets a double kill. Soul Assumption, Misery still has his Healing Ward, it's gonna get into range in just a second. No Tail, they're looking for somebody in the trees, they find out Mag, there's the Kinetic Field, they bring him down with Thunderstrike, he's gonna die. Triple kill for Kuroki. His creeps doing all the work. Misery was chasing after the birds. Can't find them. Circles being drawn by Illidan. It looks like he's a bit mad about this game currently. The tier 1 tower taking a fall. Kuroki shapeshift. Glyph is going to go, but it only prolongs the life of the tower for just a bit longer here.
And this is going to be an easy tower pickup for Secret off the back of that nice little team fight. And if we look ahead at gold and experience, gold is going to be closing in towards that 10,000 gold advantage. It's about 8,000 right now. Experience is about the same as well, so Secret definitely with a commanding advantage, and we talked about their late game presence, so this is a tough game for VPP.
Tough is an understatement, my friend. This is a very hard game. This is
I'm not sure how they come back into this game.
I think this is an almost impossible game, actually. Shadowblade for Illidan. Ice Blast is going to sail through. Another Glyph coming in. It's going to connect on absolutely... I think the Trill might hit on Illidan.
Oh, they actually
Blade Fury
know
going.
That
they saw
Illidan
him,
was
it looks
there.
Like.
Yeah.
Radiant's bottom tower. I don't think they have a gem currently. Meanwhile, top lane, they do get the kill onto one. Puppy actually got on low, but he does get poisoned. No, but S4's here. He does have Coil. He's not going to chase down DK Phobos. He's going to clean up the wards. Meanwhile, Kuroki continues to split push bottom. They're not really forcing any rotations yet, but it's only a matter
of
time.
He has book 3, right? Okay. It's flying out to him. I was wondering where his book... Because he only has book 1 on his hero.
He's
That's actually
investing.
Scary that he's been that strong with only book 1.
He's 3-1-3, Hal, Chilling Touch, and Misery doing most of the work. who, by the way, is 200 gold away from his Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah, that's frightening. Ags on this hero with level 11 ults is extremely scary.
Level
does 9 jumps.
Ult.
It's basically the same as a level 16 ult.
I mean, there's a little bit of math in there, but yeah, basically the same.
No, it's the same. It turns 6 jumps into...
you mean as regular level 16 ultimate. My bad, I'm sorry. Thought you were talking about the Aghanim's ultimate. I was like, that's not right.
Nope.
Broke you down bottom, continues his push. Aghs is now done for misery, and you're just not going to survive. I think the Shadowblade and Shadow Dance for Slark will allow him to survive, but he's the only one. Yeah. No, they're going to die. They're just going to die.
I mean, they have the Book 3 now against the Shadowblade for Slark, so the Shadowblade is actually not going to provide any protection or regeneration, for that matter.
It's really just Shadow Dance. And actually, that's the surprising thing, is why did he go for a Shadowblade against a Book 3 Lycan?
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, the cost is very low for what you get out of it. You get 22 damage and 30 attack speed. It's been reduced in cost in the previous patch, so makes it an even more effective item onto Slark. I'm just not sure that this was the game for it. I think going for... I kind of understand, because he probably feels like he can't fight toe-to-toe against these other heroes on the side of Secret. Like, I don't think, like, is a Slark, you can't fight against Lycan 1v1. He's just going to completely destroy you, especially with the book available. So maybe thinking he has to dodge in and out of fights to be effective, so maybe that's the mindset here for Illidan, but it's not going to be too effective against this Book 3.
Well, we have a pause. Disconnect coming out from Lil. Apparently more latency lag issues. There were some issues earlier in the day for Star Ladder, and they seem to be continuing onward here and into Dota Pit. So
I was told I was supposed to have some Mott Pax jokes during pauses.
I also would like those very much, please. Mott Pax, let's go, buddy.
Looks like we're getting a drawing from Kuroki.
I don't know. We have all of our tier 1 towers up. That's what he's saying currently.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure there's no other reason to draw that line.
That's what he's saying, actually. Oh, it looks like he is back in the game, so it's going to be a quick pause.
Easy pause. Oh boy, Mott Pax is not ready for the Mott Pax jokes.
Mm-mm.
I went to buy some camouflage trousers the other day, but I couldn't find any. Ladies and gentlemen, Mott Pax, our stats man, he'll be here all week. Pounce, Kuroki, Shapeshift going to go through. Illidan has to Shadow Dance now. Ice Blast is going to hit, but they won't follow up. Maybe now? Actually FNG just dies to the wolves. Oh my god, the summons do so much damage. Phobos is dead as well. Double kill for Kuroki, and... Yeah.
I think that's the set of Rex. They have the healing ward available. They have the level 2 Omni Slash. And Omni Slash can just destroy them as well at this point.
There's no Shadow Dance currently up for Slark, so if he doesn't have a Shadow Blade and Earth, the Necro 3 is still alive and Misery decides to jump on him, he will kill him.
Yep.
It is just that simple. And so Tier 3 tower is being assaulted, the Wild Axes come in, and... Yep, Tier 3 is gone, now the Rax is gonna get focused down, Hal's gonna get popped off, and... They don't need an Assault Kuros, why would they? They just kill these things so damn quickly anyways. Ancient Seal Kuroki's gonna get brought down. They do get the melee racks, get Enic Field. S4 jumps in Static Storm. They don't have anybody in the Static Storm. Mag getting chased down. Glimpse is back. Misery, Omni Slash just for Mag. Gets the kill though. And they will finish off these racks with the Lycan Wolves. Kinetic Field just to make sure everyone escapes safely. Misery does get ulted with that Venomancer. Now they're chasing after with the Shadow Dance. They might lose Misery, but if that's their only casualty, I'm sure they're okay. Misery has just enough to TP away. Is he going to make it out? Essence Shift, he lives! He lives with about 20 HP. Oh my god, Misery. They didn't lose any hero in that fight. They take Arax for free after a Poison Nova.
That's got to be heartbreaking for VPP. They probably thought, all right, we lose this Rex, but at least we're going to kill the farm Juggernaut. But
yeah.
Surviving with about 20 HP as he TPs into the fountain.
Lycan is shapeshifted, and he is chasing after some heroes. Kinetic Field goes. They're chasing after Illidan Storm
FNG
and Crawl. Oh, the Ice Blast Snipe from Puppy. And Lycan gets the kill onto FNG. And I think if you're Virtus Pro Polar, you might need to be looking towards game number 3 here.
Yeah, they're probably talking about what went wrong, and I think most of what went wrong this game was in the picking fist.
Axes, they do get a consolation prize and no tail, so he goes down. Puff jumps in, double damage rune, okay, he's dead. Kroki also gets the, he actually gets the kill because of the summons. Misery's gonna come in. Omni slash onto DK Phobos. It is connecting through onto some of the wards here, I believe. No, Mag getting caught out. There's gonna be the roar into S4. He is in some trouble. Mag's getting right clicked down. They get the double kill. S4. He does live at about 20 HP. No Jaunt 3. He actually stays. The healing ward's gonna heal him back up, and the tier 2 tower is gonna fall. Alright, Secret take 4, and they lose 1. That's it.
Yeah. Radiant's middle tower. Yeah, I imagine at this point VPP are just talking about the game and what went wrong and what they can do for the next game. I think their picks felt a little strange to me. I really think they were actually looking towards that Lycan as the last pick. It makes a lot of sense for their draft, and after it got stolen by Secret, it just doesn't seem like the Beastmaster just doesn't fit at all. And
it's literally Roar for Misery, I think, but even that, it's actually...
What has Beastmaster done this game?
Nothing. He's died. He's roared maybe Puppy once or twice. He's gotten a kill on the Ancient Apparition. That's great.
I mean,
he's
more poor than this Ancient Apparition.
Now, that's a problem. Well, Puppy does have a Midas, to be fair. Mag has no such luxury. He does have a Blink Dagger, but... This is not an easy game for Brody Footballers, Mag.
And this draft not working out for VPP, so they're going to have to go back to the drawing board, either pick something like they did in the last game. I actually liked their draft a lot in the previous game. It felt very planned, and...
You have to look at the upside here. This does give them the chance, if they do lose this game, for a reverse all kill coming in, so...
What a storyline that would be.
It would be quite the storyline. They would be down 2-0, losing heartbreakingly in that first game. Second game, they kind of went on tilt. They haven't lost yet, but... I mean, all they have to do for Secret, I think, is push into the base and just take this melee racks mid, and from that point on, it's just impossible.
They even have an Aegis on Kuroki.
Don't say we'll get spotted and that he's gonna fall, but that's a really dumb line to say when you're dying under the weather. The bad Dota jokes, man.
Oh come on, he controls the weather, lightning. He's the lightning god, right?
I guess so. He has static storm. He doesn't control rain.
Nope.
It's more lightning than it. Yeah, it's more. He's pretty much like the brother
Thunder
of Razor.
Strike. He's like Zeus's cousin.
Yeah, I guess so. Zeus's very, very distant cousin.
Okay,
four times removed. Dreamcall goes in. Omni slash as well. FNG. They get to kill him. One Illidan is gonna get brought low. His Shadow Dance is available. S4 is gonna have to phase shift. Now there's the Blade Fury. Illidan is just trying to just avoid everything. Kuroki meanwhile is going ham in the mid lane and. He's running away. He got the kill. He might die here to a tower hit. He's going to go down. It is the Aegis. Meanwhile, they're chasing still up in the top lane. Illidan. Illidan's tried going back in, and Misery's like, I want this kill. Misery is not fast enough. Phase boots. He's got already his drum charge on cooldown. One more hit. The phase and the jaunt away. The leap away, excuse me, from Illidan. Misery is still gating on him, though. He's still gating on him. The Blade Fury and Mag didn't have Roar, it looked like. It was on cooldown for 3 seconds, and Misery gets the kill. The Roar might come in.
With the drum.
I think he's blinking 2 seconds for Matt. Can he get this? Can he get this?
No.
I mean, he's not even going for it. Misery gets out. All right.
So the Aegis was used on Kuroki. I completely missed that, it appears.
He got poisoned over bottom as he was killing DK Phobos, I think, mid lane, and then got hit by the tower a couple of times while he was shape-shifting away. He was about here when he died with his Aegis.
Mm-hmm.
So... Yeah, and there's some clowny stuff happening top, which means they couldn't push into the mid lane, which is what Kroki wanted to do clearly. Yeah. Mag as well as the
sitting at 100
top,
HP.
So.
He could just make summons and probably kill it with the Buck 3 and Wolves, as well as the Howl.
Maybe just the Wolves. If he's sitting nearby, the Assault Curiosity level would be on, so I don't know if he
true.
Would, though.
I mean, he has the Howl. It gives 20 damage to Wolves, so he can actually probably just kill it with Wolves.
He's not going to do that, though. Aegis was just expended, so Roshan is not up anytime soon, and for Secret, it is more of the same. Farm up, get kills, try to take this Rax, and go from there. For Virtus Pro Polar, they have an immense amount of work to do. Yeah.
They're actually letting No-Tail get the farm in the top lane, so he can finish his Aghanims. He's about 100 gold away from that, so we're going to have a 28-minute Aghanims on this Disruptor. And that's pretty much going to be the nail in the coffin. Illidan's going to have... no effect anymore, even with the BKB. Unless he preemptively pops the BKB before going in.
He doesn't have the BKB yet, that's the issue. He does have it soon, but...
He's very, very close.
Regardless, though, if you look at the Ancient Apparition, he was the one getting the farm for Secret in terms of the support. And now suddenly, No Taz and Aghanim Scepter, so it's just everything that can go wrong is going wrong for Rotis Pro Polar.
Yeah.
They do have the tier 1 tower top, so there's something, but...
Puppy did go for the Midas, so it's not too surprising that he doesn't have the eggs quite as quickly. And he is buying the wards, I believe.
So they give him farm, but they give him the farm just so that he can support more.
He
just kidding.
Has eggs.
There it is. You spoke too soon. TP away, Misery going in the top. They want the tier 2, I think. S4 jaunts through, he wanted Vision, and... And they won't find anybody. Kuroki is
Lil
getting chased
actually...
down. Poison Nova, did he miss? Or was that a Venomous Gale? I'm not sure. He has Poison Nova still. Yeah, so... Roar into Kuroki. There's no team here to help him out. He's taking a bit of damage, but that actually... That Mystic Flare did nothing. It actually did nothing to him.
Now he's sitting at 2,000 life. And of course he moves like a race car. He's actually gonna just get the mid tower with the summons. Yep, and it falls.
Tier 2 top, tier 3 mid, and Rotis Pro Polar. Even when there are no heroes attacking your tier 3, they still lose it, so...
Mm-hmm.
By the way, Kuroki is 10,000 net worth ahead of Illidan Stormrage, so...
Wow. That is not something that we typically see when Illidan's playing probably his favorite hero, or at least his most played recently.
That's got to also be very disheartening. We talked about game number one and how depressing that must have been, but when you're playing your favorite hero and you have this rough of a game, you can honestly attribute some of it to the draft, but still. There's the glimpse back into FNG. He is absolutely dead. Mance is out of the silence coming through. Misery wants to Omni Slash. They get Lil. Will he Omni here? The Ice Blast coming in. He's going to Blade Fury first. Kills Lil. Gets the double kill. Illidan does pop the Shadow Dance. BKB goes through. They have Vision. They should be able to Omni Slash. They will. He has no Shadow Blade. Tries to pounce away. Misery gets the triple kill. And without Kuroki, they're going to hit these Raxes. And this is game,
I think. They're going to call GG right now.
Yeah.
Once this Rax falls.
Phobos got brought back, but this is too much now. No. Kuroki will take down the mid Rax. There's the Static Storm. Phobos gets caught in, waiting ripped. And the Aghanim Scepter is going to continue to bring him down slowly but surely. The slow roll of death coming through onto Virtus Pro Polar. Misery Siren stuff. He actually has Mantis Owl. Hasn't popped it off. He just dies, kind of. He got stunned up with the roar. Glimpse back in. Buyback from somebody. The Venomancer is here. He's got a Poison Nova. Phase Shift actually avoids it. No Tail is in trouble, though. He will fall. Up in the air is S4. Blinks away just in time. He's going to try to Phase Shift and jump through S4. Houdini himself still surviving. And he gets out.
Puck's extraordinarily hard to kill without a Hex once you get the Yule Scepter. There's just so much time of where you're completely invulnerable.
Well, at least they get the Aghanim
Scepter. Oh, and he gets a regen, of course. Of course.
It's only S4, man. Only he can get these runes.
Max actually surprisingly rich considering the state of the game. He had a really rough lane up against that Ancient Aberration and Disruptor. Yep, there's the GG.
Bit of an anticlimactic ending, unfortunately, but Sequel were just too far ahead.
There's no way that BPP can come back from this game.
So they look to game number three, and they hope to nullify this 2-0 advantage that Sequel currently have. It's been a tough road thus far. Again, we talked about the heartbreaking first game loss again.
This was just a draft, I think. I would say that with this draft, they put themselves at a severe disadvantage because not only